fun. It's like three videos in a row, and they all are kind of honestly related to each other. Does my hair look slightly better today? Because part of the thing I did is I didn't like do the messy look. I did more of a cleaner look, and I think it helps the appearance of my hair. Of course, that's an ironic thing. Here I am about to talk about how cool it is to be bald. Yeah, that's a paradox, isn't it? But let's talk about Eddie Santiago. He had left a comment on I Am Angry Hair Transplant Hulk Smash, and here's part of what he said. Quote, I agree with you 100%. If anything, balding has only made more opportunities for me. I get a lot of compliments from beautiful women about looking good with a bald head. Also, because of my unique situation, being the only bald Latino in my school, I was given the opportunity to be part of our college's recruiting team. It made me stand out from amongst my peers. End quote. I love this. Thank you for sending this comment to me. This is great. Thank you. Look, a couple things I want to point out real quick in this video, or in this comment here. I like how the closing line, it made him stand out. See, it's funny because there's this fear of, oh no, I'm not going to fit in. I don't have hair. And here he has said, forget that. I'm going to use this to my advantage. I'm going to stand out. Okay. And then did you see the other cool thing is? He got a job because of it. Okay. I just made a video talking about this fear that, oh, I'm not going to get a job if all things are equal and I don't have as much hair as the next guy, then I won't get the job. He got the job. He stood out. So this is employment gained. And at the beginning of it, he talked about the beautiful women and acknowledge it. They point it out and they say he looks good with it. So, like, we're debunking all these myths from Tommy Two Bats the other day, you know, saying that girls won't find you attractive, you can't get a job. Like, and here's our friend, Santiago, debunking this myth. Oh, boy. This has, like, just been... What a week. What a week of just, like, me being right. And then people backing me up. So the conclusion is this. At the end of this week, here's the conclusion. Okay? I really think it's better to be bald. Now, how soon you want to speed that up, you've probably got more advantages being bald. I really do. Because you're not going to become a politician or a criminal. So you enjoy your hair while you have it. And then when you don't, you shave it off. And I got to be honest. Oh man, as I was going to bed last night, I was thinking about this. So I know that a lot of you were here before I could actually legally talk about it, but I've got this contract at the end of the year. I have to have hair for the rest of the year. You'll find out next year about it. But, oh man, if only I could just buzz my hair off. Oh, it's in my blood, it's in my soul. I'm not going to because I can't legally, really, but all I can see is advantages of just, it's that simple. You look, you say, okay, I'm dealing with my fact I'm losing my hair. I'll make it work for now. I'm Norwood 3. And then I don't have to commit to hair. Like, I can just get rid of it. I mean, again, for this one thing that I have to do. But like you're different. Like, you could just do it. So I'll have the rest of my life to just enjoy, like, not worrying about it. Like, you can just do whatever you want to do. It's not a disadvantage to be bald. You're not becoming an actor. You're not becoming a crook, and you're not becoming a politician. And our friend Santiago here just told us that women approach him and tell him that he's more attractive. He got a job and he stands out. He used it to his advantage. We've learned a lot this week, haven't we? Thank you for being a part of it. Now, I will close with this. My sister sent me some pictures of when I was 18, Norwood 1 in 1999. So I'll be working on that this weekend. So look forward to that. I think we're going to have a lot of fun. Thanks for being a part of this. I love you, man.